Hi buddies, welcome back to my channel George Explorer, and I'm so happy that you joined me today in this video. And friends, as you know, we have explored so many places in Mumbai city over the past several months, so that's why for a change I decided to explore some other areas away from Mumbai city. So we explored Karjat and Mathura last week. Mathura is a popular hill station near Mumbai. We visited Mathura last week, and today also we're going to visit some places away from Mumbai city. Right now I am in this small town called Titwala. Titwala is around 55 to 60 kilometers away from Mumbai city. It's well connected by road and railways. There are so many trains operate between Mumbai CST to Titwala. It will take around 1 hour 40 minutes to 1 hour 45 minutes from CST to Titwala. There are so many trains operate. So I'm in Titwala right now. So this place is, Titwala is especially popular because of this particular temple, Siddhi Vinayak temple, Titwala. And don't get confused with this temple with the other one in South Mumbai. That's also Siddhi Vinayak temple in Prabha Devi, South Mumbai. That's a huge temple, so popular. This is also popular among people staying nearby, this place, in Titwala and the surrounding areas. This is also very age-old temple, I think around more than 800 years old temple. So we are going to explore that. I have not been to Titwala before. The first time I came to this place. Let's go and explore this place. I'm already in Titwala. I just a while ago I got down at Titwala railway station, and I'll show you the station premises on my return. Okay. Now we are heading to Titwala Ganpati temple, Titwala, Siddhi Vinayak temple, Titwala. Okay. So stay tuned. And friends, this is the place where I am right now. This is this road. If you go straight way, this road leads to Titwala Ganpati temple. It will take around 10 to 15 minutes, approximately 15 minutes walking distance from Titwala railway station to this temple, Siddhi Vinayak temple, Titwala. And this road leads to that temple. And I'm wondering, here too you get to see several high rises coming up. It's a small town area, not city, but here too you come across such high rises here and there. So now I am heading to the temple. This is the road to the temple. This is the scene on my way to the temple. You can see all this. You can see sugarcane juice vendor here too. That's omnipresent. This is a sugarcane juice vendor that you get to see everywhere all over Maharashtra, not only in Mumbai and suburb, but in Maharashtra you get sugarcane juice is so popular, especially in summer season. People drink in gallons sugarcane juice because the summer heat is unbearable in Mumbai. Today I think today's temperature is around 38 degrees Celsius. It's too hot. Heat wave conditions still prevails in the entire Maharashtra. It's so hot, extremely hot. You get to see small garden here. It's a small garden and some pottery shop here. It's a pottery shop. And let's go. You get to see in the entire village and small town areas. Andapav, na? Andapav, again?
Andapav, Vazadi.
Okay. It's boiled eggs and bread. It's so popular in the village areas of Maharashtra, village and small town areas. And here also you get to see some stuffs here. What is this? Chana. Okay. Then let's go straight. This is the sea around me. There are small shops and apartment complexes. It's a small town, but neat and beautiful. The only thing is the extreme heat is unbearable right now. You can see green spaces like this on the way. It's a beautiful. There's a mangroves and some kind of trees. I don't know. This is mangrove. You can see there are buildings. Residential towers are there. And you get to see small shops. This is these are also vegetable and fruit vendor. This is watermelon. This is watermelon, so popular fruit in summer. I also like watermelon during summer. On this is summer fruit, and this is the area near the temple. Temple is very close by. This Siddhi Vinayak temple is only 5 minutes from here. And the friends, I finally made to this temple premises. This is the temple premises. You can see the temple out there. It's a small, very small temple, but so popular and age-old temple. Over 800 years old. Over 800 years old temple. This is the temple premises. And you can also see one roadside dargah. This is a dargah just opposite, bang opposite of this temple. Hazrat Daji, Hazrat Pir Haji Jalaluddin Baba dargah. This is a small roadside dargah just opposite of this temple. Now let's go to the temple. Now you can see of the parking lot. This is a parking area of this temple. And plus, this is extreme hot now. Extremely hot. That's why you hardly get to see many people right now. And let's see. Let's go and see the temple. And ahead that the video taking is not allowed inside the temple, but you can take video outside. So let's see. And you can see small water body in this temple. It's so beautiful. It's amazing. And there are people sitting here. It's a sitting area for people come and relax. This here, people come and relax. This is very old, over 800 years old temple. This is the temple. This is the temple. The yellow structure. You can see. This is the temple, over 800 years old. Siddhi Vinayak temple, Chittuala. And from these are the stalls selling puja items, offering to the deity. These are various types of puja items, and coconut, and this is laddu, the sweet kind of sweet dishes, various kind of statues made of metals and clay. And you can see various types of puja items, various kinds of puja items here. The coconut and so many types, various types of. And, now finally gonna enter the temple. This is entry, I think. There are several types of statues here. And the statues of Lord Ganesha. It's so beautiful, isn't it? And here also, there are so many stalls selling puja items and offerings to Lord Ganesha, and also small various types of statues of Lord Ganesha like this. And there are so many stalls, hundreds of stalls next to this temple. My God, see so many statues. Various types of figures of Lord Ganesha are made of different materials. And the hundreds of figures. Figures of Lord Ganesha. And these are jewelries. So I'm going to enter the temple. The offering, this is my offering to the Lord in the temple. This is the entry area, and since the shooting is not allowed, I'm going to stop video taking right now. I'll continue once I get out. This is a drinking water facilities also here. It's a filtered water, drinking water. At first now I just came out of this main sanctum of this temple. I can shoot video from here. This is the same pond. It's not a lake, it's a pond. A very huge pond next to this temple. Now what I'm going to do, there's a beautiful walking garden. Yes, walking garden next to this temple. Now I'm going to enter this garden surrounding this lake, surrounding this pond. There's a beautiful walking garden next to this temple surrounding this pond. Now I'm going to enter this garden, this garden gate. Okay. This garden, the garden area next to this temple. You can see that pond over there, and this is the walking garden, and there's also seating arrangements for people who can come and sit, relax here. And this walking garden, okay, I didn't know such a thing exists here, and I just came to know. I just came to know about this garden, and yes, it's beautiful, flowering, various types of flowers, flowering plants here. You can see, so I didn't see any flowers here. It's a different types of kind of flower. I don't know what type of flower it is. And this is a walking garden, basically it's for people come and relax. Okay, that's all. It's not a it's not a typical garden, but it's just for people to come and relax. Okay, here you can see some kind of flowers. It's a bougainvillea. What do you call it? I don't know. I suppose it's a bougainvillea. flower. Bougainvillea. Bougainvillea. I hope I'm pronounced correctly. Bougainvillea. So much greenery. And here also on the opposite side, these are the mangrove area. This is a mangrove, most probably. So yes, this is a mangrove. Mangroves and some kind of trees also in between. Okay, plus you get to see some residential complexes on the other side. This is a garden area surrounding this pond next to this temple. And from this one interesting side here, you can see it's come some kind of a bird, a flock of birds sitting on this totally black, kind of black bird. I don't know what bird it is. And that's a kind of black bird. And you also see the same birds here on in the tree above this tree. You can see this, you can see it's so beautiful. It's a totally black. I don't know what type of bird it is. If you know, please tell me. And from this place, or this temple, Siddhi Vinayak temple, is a popular landmark in Titwala, attracts devotees from far and wide, and holds a special place in the hearts of devotees. And the people flock to this place, flock to this temple throughout the year, especially during Ganesh Chaturthi, which is an important and popular festival in Maharashtra. And first, now I just came out of the temple premises, and now walking through the streets next to this temple, and I realized that Titwala has embraced development in various sectors. Its proximity to Mumbai has helped economic growth and infrastructure development here. You can see several residential towers and upcoming buildings along the streets. All these are towers, and this one of the snow temple that is common in Maharashtra, roadside temple here. There is one. You also get to see this vendor selling fruits and vegetables here. These are fruits, and you get to see mango. These are mango season. All these are organic fruits, and the grapes and various types of fruits. All these are organic fruits and vegetables directly from villages. And that is the specialty of small towns in Maharashtra. You get to buy 100% organic vegetables and fruits. These are organic fruits and vegetables. See, all these are organic. Mango and watermelon and banana. And of course, now we're going to have some sugarcane juice. This is a popular refreshment during summer. This is my sugarcane juice, fresh, without ice. I don't like ice. I don't put ice in sugarcane juice. And it's very refreshing, very energetic, especially during summer days. And plus, in recent years, Titwala has witnessed rapid urbanization and infrastructure development, transforming it into a residential and commercial hub that you can clearly understand by looking around. Okay, now heading to the Titwala railway station from the ticket train, and get down at one another interesting place called Shahad. Shahad is also one another peaceful and interesting town next to Titwala. So I heard. So we are going to explore that place also. So before ending this video, I want to show you this place called Shahad. Okay, so please stay tuned. And this is the marketplace next to the Titwala railway station. You can see all this crowd, various types of businesses and shops, and so much crowd here. This is so common everywhere, whether it is a village or town or city. Marketplace next to the railway station is so crowded anywhere, everywhere in Mumbai. That's so common. You can see all types of shops and various types of shops and businesses all around, and so much crowd. And this is the marketplace next to the Titwala railway station, and that is the station you can see. And this is the station. It's a small station, two or three platforms, and now heading to the platform. I don't need to take a ticket or pass because I already have a return ticket with me. I'm at this platform number, I think, 3. And this is the CST 10, fast 10, and this one 599, CST fast. From here. And okay, my train comes at 6 p.m. Now it's only 5:45. I have to wait 10 minutes. So, stay tuned. So much travel. I didn't just wait this much travel now. And I finally made to the destination, Shahad railway station. And I'm heading to the other side. This is the railway track. It's only 2 platforms here. It's a small station. Yeah, now heading out Shahad railway station. So this is the situation outside the station. So crowded because it's evening time. And this is also market area next to Shahad railway station. Every marketplace, every station has a market area next to the railway station. You can see the overbridge next to the Shahad railway station. And just under the bridge, you can see all this two-wheeler parking space. And they manage the space very efficiently. Anyway, and from the Shahad also almost the same, just like Chitwala. Nothing much different. I get the same vibe here also, but the only difference I see in Shahad next to the railway station is all these high rises, residential towers. All these are latest residential towers next to the railway station. Shahad railway station. So this is the only difference I see. I think Shahad has many more skyscrapers, residential towers, than Chitwala. That's the only difference I see. There are so many residential towers here next to the railway station, Shahad railway station. You can see all these are latest residential towers. Remember, this is a small town, not a city. Okay. There are so many hundreds of such skyscrapers here in Shahad. So that is the difference I find between Shahad and Chitwala. This is much more developed, I think, than Chitwala. Chitwala is developing, but still it's a town. Now friends, I'm taking you to one another very interesting place in Shahad, Birla Mandir, Birla Temple. This temple is so popular because of architecture, and of course several Bollywood Hindi films have been filmed at this location, at this temple. So I'm so curious to see this temple now, so let's go and see. I took a shahad rickshaw from here, and it's not too far, let's see. I just got out of the rickshaw here. Now to cross the road and walk through that narrow lane, you can see this lane to reach the temple, Birla Temple. This lane going up. I don't know where it leads me. It's on a hillock, I think, this temple. And so to climb the steps. I'm really exhausted. This is the temple. There are so many steps, I think, close to 100. I didn't count, but I think not less than 100 steps. Oh. I had a long day today. Plus, climbing these steps is so arduous. So, it's a huge, difficult task for me. Anyway, I reached the temple. These are the various puja items, offerings to the deity. Here too, you get to see all these puja items here. There are steps again. There are more steps to climb. I thought this is the final. More steps to climb. I'm extremely sorry guys, taking video inside the temple is not allowed, so I'm not able to show you the temple. I'm so sorry. So and there's no point visiting the temple if we can take the video, because I came here for you. And okay, you know, so heading back to the railway station, Shah railway station, from there going to take a train, CST train. And now finally I'm signing off here. I'll be back with some other video content. Till then, goodbye. Thanks so much for your support. Thank you.